الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وآله الطيبين وأصحابه المكرمين. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في شان حبيبه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد كما تحب وترضى بأن تصلي عليه. Our great Imam and Shaykh Tariqat, Shaykh al-Hadith, Hazrat Allama Maulana Riyaz Ahmed Sahib Samdani, Madras Lahul Ali, the host of this program, the Imam of this Masjid, Hazrat Maulana Qari Tariq Mehboob Sahib Madrasah Ulali, my younger brother Dr. Rashid Zia Naeemi, and all my respected brothers, sisters and friends, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As you can see through my voice, I am not feeling well. I am coughing a lot. And it is very difficult, extremely difficult for me with this cough to speak. However, I managed to arrive here just for the sake of having some barakah of Urs of Ghawth. So today that is the only purpose. I will try to speak very briefly, if you could kindly forgive me. Hazrat Ghawsul Alam, Tariqus Sultanat, Makhdoom, Syed Ashraf Jahangir, Simnani, Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi, according to one of the historians' report, was born in 712 year of Hijrah. He lived in this world for 120 years and he passed away 806 years ago in the year 832. At the age of 4 years, 4 months, 4 days, he started teaching in his own home. He was a prince. He was the son of a king. His father's name is Sultan Syed Ibrahim Simnani. Rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, who comes from the family of Imam Hussain radiyallahu ta'ala. He is a Husseini Sayyid. And his mother, Sayyida Khadija radiyallahu ta'ala anha, was a Hassani Sayyid. At the age of 7, he memorized the whole Quran. At the age of 14, he graduated in all the disciplines of that time's educational requirements. And at the age of 15, he became a king, a ruler. It was a great challenge for him, and he accepted that challenge. When he was only 25 years old, Hazrat Khidr alayhi salam came to see him and told him, "O Ashraf, if you want to rule spiritually the whole of the world, abandon this political throne." He followed the teachings of Hazrat Khidr alayhi salam and he resigned as a king. And because it was suggested to him by Hazrat Khidr alayhi salam that he needs to go to India to Hazrat Alaul Haq Padmi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi in Bengal. He started his journey towards Bengal. After 2 years of extensive traveling, he arrived in Pandwa, at that time a small village where Sheikh Alaul Haq, originally he was from Lahore, was staying there. He met him, became a murid of Sheikh Alaul Haq Pandvi in Silsila Chishtiya, and then he lived over there at least for 6 years. Today, the system is a bit different. We find a sheikh, we become a murid, and we disappear, isn't it? We feel that whatever we wish to take, we would take in a few minutes sitting and sohba and company. But that is not the case, and that was not the case at that time. Even today it is not possible, although we believe in this technological age that things could easily be granted by our shares. But it is not possible. It takes time. After staying for 4 years in the company of his sheikh and serving the community over there in that area, in the time of Salatul Fajr, at the time of Salatul Fajr, it was Shab-e-Barat, he got the title of Jahangir from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he is called Jahangir. And then after his staying for a further 2 years, he was ordered by his sheikh to go where he is resting now, in Kachhocha Sharif. At that time, it was a preaching center of Hindu faith. 500 yogis or the religious scholars of Hindu faith used to stay there. But he was ordered by his sheikh that you need to go there. So he traveled, he set out for this journey, and he arrived there. In the beginning, these Hindu religious scholars confronted him very, very rigorously and strongly, but finally they surrendered and they all became Muslims. And that is the area where I think every Muslim household has some sort of connection with Hazrat Makhdoom, Syed Ashraf Jahangir, Simnani, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Because if Islam is there, if Muslim culture is there, if khanqahs and madrasas and mosques are there in that area, it is all the sadaqah of and the effort of Hazrat Syed Ashraf Jahangir Simnani rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. History informs us that he traveled abroad twice after arriving to Kichocha Sharif. What was the purpose? Was he going to other countries for holidays? Today, we travel a lot for holidays, isn't it? We go to Malaysia, we go to Dubai, we go to other places with an intention of relaxing. He did not go for holidays. He himself says in his Lataif-e Ashrafi, the book written by Nizamuddin Yamani, which is a collection of his words, Lataif-e Ashrafi in Persian language. Now it has been translated and published from Karachi as well. So he says that all the time the purpose of my journey have been, number one, to take benefit by visiting other awliya Allah. That was the very first purpose of his journey. Istifada from other awliya Allah. Number two, he says, I traveled so that I could be of any help to the humanity. Those who were in need, those who were looking for some help and support, I used to offer them support irrespective of who they are, what is their color, what is their family, what is their religion. Number three, the purpose was to reform the powerful. Those who are powerful in terms of money, in terms of politics, those who are rulers, governors, kings, he used to see them and he prepared a syllabus for their reform, for their moral development, and he used to spend time with the rulers and the kings and the governors and the elite people for this very purpose, in order to reform them. And number four, he says that wherever I went, the purpose has always been to help the weak, to support the weaker section of the communities. So these were the four reasons he traveled abroad twice. In the second journey of abroad, overseas, he also visited Baghdad, where he encountered Nurul Ain Hazrat Abdul Razzaq rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, who was the son of his sister. Hazrat Makhdoom Sahib was born by the dua of a majzoob, his name is Ibrahim, after three daughters to Sultan Syed Ibrahim Simnani rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. He took Nurul Ain with him, he brought him to Kichocha Sharif, he trained him, educated him, and nourished him with great spiritual talents and made him his successor. All the existing and the previous people of Kichocha Sharif, they are the children of Hazrat Nurul Ain Abdul Razzaq rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Hazrat Makhdoom Sahib did not marry. He had no children at all. So there is no any biological relationship of these Piran-e-Kiram of Khijoch-e-Muqaddasa with Makhdoom Sahab Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh. They are all children of Hazrat Abdul Razak Nurulain, who was the son of one of his sisters, and he was a Gilani Sayyid. He was biologically a child of Hazrat Ghawsul Azam Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. My dear brothers and my dear friends, I could continue with this vivid story of his life, but the most important thing is what has been his message. Because today, in today's time, that is the shortcoming of the Muslim community in general, that we remember the heroes of Islam, but we do not care about their teachings at all. And that's why we are in a position of disgust. We have destroyed our own future religiously, and we are broken into pieces in terms of our faith. We are divided community, isn't it? There could be 101 reasons for that. One of the reasons is that we celebrate the Urs of our great heroes, but we do not care about their teachers. Hazrat Makhdoom Sahib Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi belongs to Chishtiya Silsila, to Chishtiya order, isn't it? Hazrat Khaja Mohinuddin Chishti radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to India and he lived in India. His successor or his khalifa is Khaja Qutbuddin Bakhtiyar Kaki Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. Baba Farid Ganja Shakar of Pakpatan Sharif is the successor of Khaja Qutbuddin Bakhtiyar Kaki Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. Mehboob-e-Ilahi Hazrat Nizamuddin Auliya Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi is the Khalifa of Baba Farid, is it? One of the Khalifa of Hazrat Mehboob-e-Ilahi was Shaykh Akhi Siraj. He is known in the books of Awliya Allah as a robber of Vilaya. इनको विलायत का डाकू कहा जाता है. इनसे जब कोई मुरीद होने आता तो कहते कि भाई मुरीद तो मैं करूंगा, लेकिन एक पर्दा होगा मेरे और तुम्हारे दरमियान, और मैं तुमसे तीन सवाल करूंगा. अगर तीनों सवालों के जवाब तुमने दे दिए तब तो मुरीद कर लूंगा, और नहीं दिए तो तुम्हारी विलायत छीन लूंगा. विलायत छीन लेते थे हजरत शाह. Hazrat Alaul Haq Pandvi came to him to be his murid. He said, if you want to be my murid, you have to make wudu with boiling water. Hazrat Alaul Haq Pandvi said, I would like to have a bath with boiling water, not only wudu. Shaqi Sirajwaza means shocked. Who is this person? He himself snatched the screen and he saw Shaykh Alaul Haq Lahori Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi, and without any further questions he made him his murid. And Hazrat Makhdoom Syed Ashraf Jahangir Simnani is the murid of Shaykh Allama Lahori Pandvi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. So Makhdoom Sahab is a Shaykh of Chishtiya order, In my humble opinion, Chishtiya order has five basic ingredients. All the orders, Silsilah Naqshbandiya, Silsilah Qadiriya, Silsilah Sohrawardiya, are dear to us. We respect all the shuyukh. We respect most Hazrat Sayyidina Ghawse Azam radiallahu ta'ala. Without any doubt, we respect the shuyukh of Naqshbandiya order also. We respect the shuyukh of Sohrawardiya order also. In reality, they are the same, but in apparent ways, they have different methods and ways for reaching to Allah Almighty. So, Chishtiya order is also based upon five basic ingredients. Number one, Muhabbat, love. It is the teaching of all the Chishti Sufis that you must love each and everything around you. If you want to be a good Chishti, you must be a loving father, you must be a loving son, you must be a loving daughter, you must be a loving husband, you must be a loving wife. So love or muhabbat or hub is one of the basic ingredients of Chishti order. Number two, Judo Sakha, generosity and hospitality. Hazrat Makhdoom Sahab, in his own way, in Lataif-e-Ashraf, he says that one who gives to someone something and retains something for himself or herself, he or she is a sakhi. One who gives everything to someone, nothing leaves for himself or herself, he is jawwar. But one who gives everything to someone and himself faces difficulty and problem, he is a person of isar or sacrifice. This is how he defines these three different, very similar terms in his Lataif-e-Ashrafi, the famous book of the teachings of Hazrat-e Makhdoom, Syed Ashraf Jahangir Simnani. So Judo Sakha, or generosity and hospitality, is the second most important ingredient of Chishti order. Anybody who claims to be a Chishti or Ashrafi must be hospitable, must be generous. The third most important ingredient of Chishti order is to be humble, tawazu. Tawazu is something Khaja Ghareeb Nawaz says, radiallahu ta'ala, that nafs parasti or khud parasti, worshipping your own ego or worshipping your own personality, is like worshipping idols. Budparasti. Khudparasti or nafsparasti, budparasti. Aur jab tak isse kisi ko nijaat nahi mil jaye, wo Allah ko nahi pa sakta. This is the saying of Khaja Muhyiddin Chishti, radiallahu ta'ala. So tawazu, or to be humble, is one of the great basic ingredient of Chishti order. The fourth most important ingredient is to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. In one of the sayings in Lataif-e-Ashrafi, Hazrat Makhdoom sahab says that a person cannot be a wali, a believer, a mu'min or a Muslim cannot become a wali unless he or she follows Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qawlan, in his words, fi'lan, in his actions, zahiran, externally, batinan, internally, and halan, and he or she must be in a hall, in a situation where his whole body is expressing itself that it is the slave of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So this is a basic ingredient of Chishti order, that anybody who is a Chishti must be the follower of Sharia, must be the follower of Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And the last and final ingredient, in my opinion, of the Chishti order is khidmat-e-khalq, serving the creation of Allah. Hazrat Khaja Muin Chishti radiallahu ta'ala anhu is reported to have said that to serve a man or a woman who is in need is the real worship of Allah Almighty. Aine bandagi hai ke koi kisi ki madad kare, makhlooq-e-khuda pe koi raham khaye. We need to be kind, we need to be sympathetic, we need to be loving to all our relatives, to all our family members, to all our Muslim brothers and sisters, and to all the human beings. Otherwise, how could we become a Chishti? How could we become an Ashraf? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to be a real follower of these great Sufis. This is like it, and it is resulting in the destruction of so many things we used to have in our home, in our families. So my submission tonight will be that we need to follow the teachings of these great saints and Sufis. If we follow them, become the torch bearer of this country, and we become the light at the end of the tunnel for the society we live in. Thank you very much. Jazakumullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Ah! Yeah. جہاں جہاں سے احباب حاضر ہوئے ہیں عقائد و عالم جناب محمد رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے وسیلہ جلیلہ سے مخدوم صاحب کی نسبتوں کے توسل سے سب کی حاضری کو منظور و مقبول علماء کرام جس محبت اور پیار کے ساتھ مخدوم صاحب کی سیرت اور ان کی صورت اور ان کے اعمال اخلاق کے بارے تعلیمات کے بارے ملفوظات کے بارے جو کچھ پیش کیا ہم سب کو اس پر عمل کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے ہم سب کو پیارے مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے پیاروں کے نقش قدم پر چلنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے سب کی نیک حاجات مرادات کو پورا فرمائے سب مسلمان بیماروں کو صحت و شفا عافیت تندرستی عطا فرمائے جن جن دوستوں کی طرف سے دعاؤں کے لیے کہا گیا ہے اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ کی سب نیک حاجات مرادات کو پورا فرمائے جو مشکلات ہیں اللہ دور فرمائے زمینی آسمانی آفات بلیات حادثات صدمات سے اللہ حضور کی ساری امت کو ہم سب کو محفوظ فرمائے حاضرین کی جو نیک حاجات مرادات ہیں اللہ ان کو پورا فرمائے اس ملک کے اندر رہنے والے ہمارے بچوں کو بچیوں کو اللہ پیارے مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے دامن رحمت کے ساتھ وابستہ کی نصیب فرمائے اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ حضرت علامہ شاہد رضا صاحب کو صحت عطا فرمائے شفا عطا فرمائے یہ ہمارا سرمایہ ہیں اس ملک کے اندر انہوں نے دین جو خدمات انجام دین ہیں دی ہیں اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ نے قبولیت کا اظہار عطا فرمایا ہے اللہ مزید اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ نے صحت عافیت تندرستی کے ساتھ دین کی خدمت کرنے کا موقع عطا فرمایا ہے اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ دو جہاں کی برکات سے مالا مال فرمائے اور اس ملک کے اندر رہتے ہوئے دینی خدمات کرنے کا زیادہ سے زیادہ ان سب کو موقع عطا فرمائے اس ذوق و شوق محبت اور پیار کے ساتھ اللہ مختار صاحب نے ان کے ساتھیوں نے اس محفل کو سجایا ہے اللہ کو جزائے خیر عطا فرمائے اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ سب کو دامے درمے قدمے سخنے جس قدر احباب نے حصہ لیا خواتین حاضر ہوئی ہیں اللہ سب کو دو جہاں کی برکات سے مالا مال فرمائے اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ اس وقت عالم اسلام پر جو مصائب و آلام پڑے اللہ ان سے حضور کی ساری امت کو محفوظ فرمائے برما کشمیر فلسطین عراق افغانستان پاکستان اور یمن کے اندر لیبیا اور سیریا کے اندر جس قدر مسلمانوں پر ظلم و ستم ڈھائے جا رہے ہیں اللہ تبارک تعالیٰ خود کرم فرما کر مظالم سے حضور کی ساری امت کو نجات ہم سب کو پیارے مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی سچی محبت اور غلامی نصیب فرما آپ کے نقش قدم پر چلنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے مخدوم صاحب کی تعلیمات پر ملفوظات پر تمام مشائخ اہل سنت کی تعلیمات پر ان کے ملفوظات پر ہم سب کو سچے دل سے محبت اور پیار کے ساتھ عمل کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے انت خیر الراحمین ان اللہ و ملائکتہ یصلون علی النبی یا ایھا الذین آمنوا صلوا علیہ وسلموا تسلیما سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين رحمة الله ورحمة الله.